Foundation, Cox Business, Home Bank, Blue Cross Blue Shield of Louisiana, and Kiwanis of Lafayette. Now, I'm excited to share with you our judging panel. We've got some really qualified people today who are going to be judging all of the finalists today. Up first, we have Ross Barrett. Ross is the founder of the holding company BVM Capital and is the managing partner for four venture funds. He's the co-founder and chairman of the software and data analytics company Lanyap Labs, LLC. Ross has worked in several branches of government, authored numerous publications, and has served as a board member for numerous organizations. When he's not traveling for work obligations, he's at home spending quality time with his family in Shreveport. Up next is Karen W. Karen is Capital One's market president for Southeast Louisiana. In this role, she connects Capital One's resources with community needs, and she plays a critical role in ensuring that Capital One lives up to the promise of investing for good. W represents Capital One as a featured speaker for numerous Future Edge and community development banking programs that enhance and expand economic opportunities for families and businesses. One of Karen's passions is volunteering time to better the community. Among the many organizations that benefit from her leadership are YMCA of Greater New Orleans, YMCA of the USA, New Orleans City Park, Boys Hope, Girls Hope, Police and Justice Foundation, Catholic Charities, Blue Ridge Leaders School, Stuart Hall School, Jesuit High School, GNOF Impact 100. Up next is Ada Womack Bell. She serves as the director of the Louisiana Small Business Development Center at Southern University and A&M College. Her area of expertise is training and consulting with both startup and existing businesses. She has over 15 years experience in working with small businesses in the private and public sector. Ada Womack Bell is the owner of A&G Consulting Group, LLC, and Womack House Publishing, LLC. Her entrepreneur ambitions are to continue to assist small businesses by providing high-quality technical assistance to existing and startups. And she wants to help build and develop Louisiana's economy. Up next, Matthew G. Stuller. Matthew G. Stuller is the founder, chief executive officer, and global strategist of Stuller Inc., which is North America's largest fine jewelry manufacturer and distributor. Matt launched his business after one semester of college, and get this, he literally sold jewelry out of the trunk of his car to jewelers across Louisiana, Mississippi, and Arkansas. Over time, though, Matt has built his business into an organization that produces 360,000 jewelry-related products that can be shipped overnight. Stuller Inc.'s primary facility is in Lafayette, Louisiana, along with subsidiaries on three continents. Matt Stuller attributes his 50 years of success to his strong customer service dedication, and he says that service is key. John W. Bordelon joins us as well, president and chief executive officer of Home Bank. He is recently elected as well as chairman of the board of directors for Home Bank. With 39 years of banking experience, John has led Home Bank to incredible growth from bank acquisitions to technological advances in banking. John is very active in the Lafayette community and serves on numerous boards of directors, including the founder of the Ragin' Cajun Athletic Foundation. John is a native of New Orleans, Louisiana, and he's a proud graduate of the University of Louisiana at Lafayette, where he played linebacker for the Ragin' Cajun football team. All right, now that we've introduced everybody, who's ready for some pitches? Next up, the four finalists you're going to hear for include students from Caddo Career and Technology Center in Shreveport, Turlings Catholic High School in Lafayette, Woodlawn High School in Baton Rouge, and the Mount Carmel Academy in New Orleans. The business ideas presented virtually today all started with a crazy idea. For these student entrepreneurs, their crazy ideas could be the beginning of a life-changing venture, and we hope it is. Today's teams include Trace Lime, Plan Pals, Clean Kit, and Safe Slit. You will see a 7-minute pitch from each of our teams. And after that, it'll be followed by a Q&A session with our judges. Once the judges have had time to ask questions, we'll give the judges a few minutes to tabulate their results using their judging rubrics. And I must let you know, in addition to being the host today, I'm also the official timekeeper, and I'm going to run a tight ship. During the student pitches, our friends from Postal Weight and Netterville will monitor the judges' tallies. Each of the teams have already won $5,000 in continuing education funds, along with other prizes. Their schools also received $2,500 for supporting the challenge. The Trust Your Crazy Idea Challenge state winning team today is going to win $10,000 in continuing education funds, and their school is going to win $5,000 to go towards future financial literacy programs. The other finalists will receive $2,500 in continuing education funds, and their schools will also receive $2,500. That's $30,000 total in prizes for today's winners across the state of Louisiana, and we would like to especially thank the Breeze Dream Foundation for making that happen. Let's get started and meet our student entrepreneurs. Up first, representing the Caddo Career and Technology Center in Shreveport, Haley DeRamis and Lauren Wise are the creators of TraceLine. It's a small, undetectable device that can be placed discreetly on your clothing. When a person feels threatened or in danger, the device can be activated, alerting authorities and designated emergency contacts within seconds. Our first virtual presentation is from Haley DeRamis and Lauren Wise from Caddo Career and Technology Center in Shreveport with TraceLine. Let's take a look at their video.
How many of you have ever been in a situation where you felt unsafe or in danger? Well, my name is Lauren Wise.
And my name is Haley DeRamis.
And we're TraceLine, and we're making the world safer. We are seniors from Captain Shreve, and we're representing Caddo Career. This is our commercial.
Has your loved one ever felt threatened or had their safety compromised?
How many times has your loved one been in a place they didn't feel safe and couldn't contact anyone? TraceLine Tracker is meant to prevent these situations from happening.
It's a discreet tracker hidden within your clothing that contacts the police within seconds of activation. TraceLine, here to make our world safer.
So, Voltaire once stated that the danger which is least expected soonest comes to us.
The number of violent incidents in the United States rose from 5.2 million in 2017 to 6 million in 2018. The number of violent crimes against victims ages 12 and older rose from 2.7 million in 2015 to 3.3 million in 2018. And then every 98 seconds, someone in the United States is sexually assaulted.
Over a nine-year period, 44% of domestic violences were not reported. One in three girls and one in seven boys will be assaulted by the time they reach 18. Elder abuse is four times as prevalent as child abuse in the United States. And 3.7 million high school students are expected to be graduated by 2020 to be thrown in the real world alone.
So what is our issue? We're here to protect everyone from unsafe and insecure environments, and that's from teens and college students to parents of concerned children who may go out a lot, and then family members of elders who have problems with their health.
So our solution was we decided to come up with a small and discreet tracker that can be hidden within your clothing. It's small enough to fit inside of a pocket. Each of the pockets would come with a tracker that would be different patterns, different fabrics, different colors and stuff to match whatever you want to wear, whether it be casual outing, athletic outing, or even dress and work clothes. The tracker can be activated with double-sided pressure, and they would set off a small vibration once the tracker had been activated. You can buy trackers and pockets separately from each other, or you can buy them in bundles. Each of the trackers would come with a water-resistant coating that allows it to not get ruined in case it were to get washed or accidentally submerged underneath water. Each of the trackers would come with at least a 5 years of service to be included into it. It would have a wireless charging feature that you could just set it on there and it would charge freely. Each of the trackers sold would also come with a code for the app.
So who are we looking at for this product? Like we said, we were looking at teens and young adults from 15 to 28, and then concerned parents of college students, new drivers, kids that are very active, like I said, and then the children of elders who want to keep their family members as safe as possible. And then, so what is different about us? So we are a discreet mini tracker that is here to ensure all civilian safety via a cheaper but more effective technology, but it's always on your person, able to be activated at any time. And then the app and the tracking device together is a combination of Life Alert and OnStar and home security features with disarming abilities and insurance charges coming from when the tracker is actually activated.
So like we mentioned previously with the app, each tracker would come with a special code that could be programmed into the app. And once the tracker had been activated, the app would alert whoever had the code, whether it be the user of the tracker or a loved one. They don't have to be shared, though, for safety reasons. The only time the location would be given would be whenever the tracker turned on and alerted the police. Whoever had the code would not get access to the location, just that it had been activated. And each of the apps shows the percentage of each tracker. So our competition could be considered the Spot Personal Tracker, Life 360, and the Reach 4 GPS. Our product is different because it is always on your person and is always able to be activated.
So our income statement, we're looking at the first 2 years, and so we're looking at about $200 per person, and to make those goods, it's going to be about $62. So we are jacking that price up just a little bit, and so for 25,000 customers is our target. We're looking at a $5 million in revenue and then around 1.5 in cost of the goods. And everything, the operation expenses was going to include the insurance for the device, getting the location of that person to the 911 centers when it's activated and such forward.
So this just kind of gives you more of a general idea of where all of our operation costs would be going for the first 2 years, with the largest portion being for legal and insurance and obviously the startup costs. Millions of people do use social media every day. That includes for video, watching videos, connecting with families, or anybody around the world. They see millions and millions of advertisements every time you get on. We would focus a lot of our advertisements through social medias like Instagram and Facebook. We would also be including commercials that would be on TV, as well as local advertisements like in the newspapers and magazines.
So we do look to expand in the future, and first we're going to start nationally and then globally. With that, we'd be pairing with companies to get the best technology we can. So the tracking abilities they'd have over there, we might not have in the United States. So to get the best look at their terrain, we'd like to pair with them.
So for the total asking cost, we would be asking for about $300,000 for all of our startups. And for the 2 years of operational expenses included, for around $1.59 million for 30% of our company. And President Calvin Coolidge once stated that there is nothing of greater importance than the conservation of a human life.
We'd like to give a special thanks to all of our mentors and teachers that helped us through this process.
Any questions?
Hi, this is Karen W. Terrific presentation. Thank you. One question, in order to be connected with the police, is there a fee there? And what would it take to get the police to agree to monitor the tracking device? Thank you.
So the fee would be like put into with all the operational kind of expenses that would be included in like the fees and the legal and the insurance and all of that stuff. Like whether or not a local police station, like it's going to be kind of up to them whether they would actually use it. We would hope that they would be able to, but that'd be like part of their decision if they would want to have another way to monitor it themselves.
Thank you.
Hi, this is Ada Womack Bell. I have a question regarding the tracking distance with measuring. How far have you guesstimated or worked on the prototype of everything as far as tracking distance?
So for tracking distance, we never really got like an exact number. We kind of just estimated, like, obviously for like several miles. We did want to use satellite location to kind of broaden that. and help expand the territory for how far it would be able to reach. But we didn't get an exact number down.
Okay. And is this product a patent pending product? You say it's unique and different than anyone else's. And as far as the legal aspect, is it going to be trademarks or patents or anything involved with this process on your, under your legal costs?
We would like it to. That's still a lot of figuring out and paperwork we have to do. Since a GPS tracker has already been invented, I'm not sure if we could get a patent for our idea or if we would have what other process we would have to go through it.
Okay, thank you.
Yes, ma'am.
Team Traceline, John Bordelon with Home Bank. You've got a little competition in this area, and you talked a little bit about how you're going to differentiate yourself. Could you speak a little bit more to how you're going to market your product versus the competition and what's going to make you stand out?
What makes us stand out a little bit more as this is something for everybody. It doesn't have one specific feature that somebody might like versus other. Like we said, we do have a little prototype made. It would be about this big or so, give or take, to be able to be hidden within like a pocket or clothing, or it could be worn and as an accessory or whatever. It could go for a bunch of different, like any gender would want to, could use it or whatever. And like we said before, with like the pockets, it could fit with any type of clothing. So we would want the best way for it to be like a discreet item. For like maximum safety, like it wouldn't be able to be seen.
Okay, thank you.
This is Ross Barrett. I had a question on your valuation. How did you derive $300,000 of investment capital for 30% of the company? And do you have any comparable companies that you can point to? Thanks.
For that number, we kind of just configured it to like whenever it came more to who, like investors, if we did reach further for this product, to kind of like, so we could have investors to kind of pitch in and help a little bit for this. That $300,000 just kind of came from a majority of what, where our startup fees would be and what would also kind of be included for the first 2 years of operation. But for otherwise, for like competition, or what was it that you said was the second part?
Oh, comparable companies. So are you aware of any other similar companies like Life 360, for example's sake, and what their valuation was? And then ultimately, what do you think this company could grow into?
Well, we did look into with the company growing, we looked into expanding into a clothing line as well to kind of help with the compatibility of our device. And so the other companies we looked at, we did look at some of their, what it took to start them up and everything. And we gave a good estimate of what it would be. So around $300,000 is what we came up with just because of, you know, with having people design the product and all the other things that come into creating the actual product itself.
Great. I really like that idea of a clothing line. I think that's incredibly clever. So I'd certainly encourage you to look into a possible partnership. That could be your distribution right there. If you have a clothing line that picked you guys up, and I think that's a great idea. And very nice presentation.
Thank you.
All right, judges, I want to thank you for your questions. And I also want to thank Haley and Lauren for your presentation and your idea.
Thank you. That is
going to be a wrap on the first presentation. At this point, we are going to give 3 minutes for our judges to do their rubrics. So let's all stay on mute, and we will be in 3 minutes. All right, judges, I believe our time is up. Once again, we want to thank all of our sponsors for this awesome event today. And I want to congratulate all of you for being the best Zoom call participants I've been on since the whole quarantine started. Everyone's using mute, and I appreciate it so much. It's time for our next, let me see if I can stop this phone from ringing. Should have put that on silent. Up next, we've got Plan Pals. Making new friends can be intimidating, and finding a way to meet people safely is even scarier. To create new connections, you can trust the ease and safety of Plan Pals. Our second virtual presentation is from Olivia Leonard, Emma Lemaire, and Haley Privat from Turlings Catholic High School in Lafayette with Plan Pals. Take it away.
We're Plan Pals, and our goal is for users to meet, greet, and repeat.
We believe that everyone deserves friendship, and our mission is to provide a safe space for people to meet and make friends.
Meet Sophie. She's a 19-year-old who graduated high school in Texas and decided to go to college at LSU. Upon arriving, she didn't know many people and decided to try a few apps to help her find friends. The first app Sophie tries is Mosey. However, Mosey focuses on making plans with existing friends, whereas Sophie wants to meet new people. Then, Sophie tries Meetup. However, Meetup focuses on large expos and group settings, whereas group settings overwhelm Sophie, and she prefers one-on-ones and small groups. Lastly, Sophie tries MeetMe. However, MeetMe was rated the most unsafe app and appeared on a list of 25 most trafficked websites in 2012. This really scares Sophie, because her number one priority is safety. Then, Sophie found Plan Pals. Our app encompasses everything Sophie was looking for and more.
Our process is easy. All Sophie has to do is create a profile, get verified through our precautionary steps, and make plans. To create a profile, Sophie must agree to the terms and conditions and enter her information. Then, she must get consent for biannual background checks to be run. Sophie will not be allowed to officially join the app without having a clear background check. Finally, Sophie will make plans and meet friends. She will also have the option to create a following and make plans with her friend circle whenever she wants. Safety is highly valued by Sophie, so she appreciates that Plan Pals implements four main safety precautions, including detailed background checks, video chats prior to meeting up, verification codes between you and the person you're meeting, and an option to send your location to someone trusted in the event of an emergency.
For safety reasons, we do not allow minors on the app, so we target the 75% of the population who are 18 and over, just like Sophie. We also implement age grouping so that an 18-year-old doesn't get paired with an 85-year-old.
In the U.S. alone, 40 million people move every year on average. And like Sophie, 8 million of those people move for college. This feeds into our target market. Sophie is just one of the 3.5 billion users who are looking online to meet friends. This user base, on average, generates $22 million in revenue per year. Our main revenue generator will be quarterly subscriptions. We will offer a basic subscription in which the user pays $9.99 and an unlimited subscription in which the user pays $14.99, which will offer more customization options and no ads. As our user base grows, our income generated by ads will also grow. On average, background checks cost $7, and because biannual background checks are required to get on the app, the user covers the cost and their payment of their basic quarterly subscription. After talking to a company specializing in background checks, as our user base grows, they will be willing to partner with us in order to reduce the cost of background checks.
There's a lot of potential for some really cool partnerships. And our target partnership would be with colleges. We feel colleges would be inclined to work with us to help lower student depression rates. First, we need investors, then a UX and UI designer to help design our web interface and keep our app up to date.
We are the founders, and we want to share a little bit about ourselves with you. Hi, I'm Haley, and I'm in pageants, and through this, I gain connections and public speaking experience.
Hi, I'm Emma. I'm a speech and debater who loves working with the many different clubs on my campus and helping manage them.
I'm Olivia, and I'm imaginative and creative. I always bring new things to the table, and I'm good at math. As a team, we are qualified because we are all from non-feeder schools and began high school not knowing anyone.
We are seeking $1 million in exchange for 10% of Plan Pals. $600,000 of the $1 million will go to advertising, and the remaining $380,000 will be used for app development, app coding, and updates, and to pay our UI and UX designer salaries.
If this was your child, could you put a price on safety? Thanks for your time. Any questions?
Hi. Hi, it's Karen W. I have a question about how you will protect the privacy of your customers. Thanks.
Hi. So we plan to run background checks, as we mentioned, and by running these background checks, the customers who get on of our app will already be secured and make sure that they're safe before they're even allowed on the platform, so other people won't have to worry about meeting dangerous people. Thank you.
John Bordelon.
Thank you.
Just a quick question. So what exactly does the app do? Is there a menu of people or groups or such? And how do you connect with other people?
So the app is a social networking app to help people find friends. All three of us entered high school coming from a non-feeder school and didn't know anyone, and plans to go to college next year. And when we go to college, we might not know anyone. So we wanted to make this app where people who don't know anyone can get on the app and find similar people with similar interests that might go to the same college as them, whereas they can meet friends and not feel as lonely on orientation day, where they know more people and they can start meeting new people as they interact in different activities.
Hello, this is Ross Barrett. I have a question on your valuation. How did you derive the fact that $1 million of equity is equal to 10% of the company?
So we believe that we will capture at least 12% of the 8 million people who move every year for college. And by capturing that 12%, they will pay the basic $9.99 subscription model, which will average into our valuation. And that is not averaging people who will pay for the unlimited subscription model.
Thank you. That's a good answer. The other question that I would have is, how do you compete with apps like Bumble that already have an offering just like this?
We believe that people will pay for safety, because safety is one of the things that all of our parents care about and all of us. And we believe that some people on Bumble or these other competitors that we have might be on those apps because they're not a perfect fit, but it's all they have. So when our app comes to market and we offer safety and we offer more specific interests and people to meet at your own college, we believe people will switch from their platform to ours.
Great, thank you.
Girls, this is Matt Stuller. Nice presentation, Olivia, Haley, Emma. Quite impressed. I am a little bit concerned on the upfront cost and not having anything to go to the investors from a prototype perspective to show how it is going to work. Any of your thoughts on how you would do that? And then secondly, the security of this with the background checks of the $7, could you give us a little more detail on what that background check would cover, who would do it, and most importantly, how effective that would be?
So for background checks, we have talked to a background check company who would be willing to partner with us down the road. Upfront cost per background check would be an average of $7, and this would be a federal run background check. So as the user pays their $9.99 subscription, they're covering their background costs and we are making a profit off of it. So after we generate a lot of users on our app platform, the background checks will cut their costs and discount every background check because we are generating so many.
All right, thank you.
Hi, this is Ada Womack-Bell again. I have a question. What year do you all see yourselves breaking even with your app? You have the additional investment, you have the cost of the app, the products and services, but when do you see you breaking even?
With our $10 million first year valuation and looking at our competitors' yearly generated revenue, we feel that after our first year in business, we will break even.
Okay, thank you.
All right, judges, I want to thank everyone for your questions and thank you, Plan Pals, for your presentation. We will now set a timer for 3 minutes in which we will allow the judges to complete their rubrics.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
All right, judges, time is up. And once again, I want to welcome everyone and thank you for joining on the Trust Your Crazy Idea Challenge. We want to thank the Breeze Dream Foundation. Once again, my name is David Dockhan. I'm with Cox Communications, and I want to reintroduce our judges real quickly just to let you know who we have making the decisions today. We've got Ross Barrett, who is the founder of the holding company BVM Capital, Karen W., who is Capital One's market president for Southeast Louisiana, Ada Womack Bell is director of the Louisiana Small Business Development Center at Southern University and A&M College. Matt Stuller is the founder, chief executive officer, and global strategist of Stuller Inc., which is the largest fine jewelry manufacturer and distributor in the nation. And also we have John Bordelon, who's the president, CEO, and chairman of the board with Home Bank. Judges, thank you again so much for doing this today. And students, thank you for your pitches. Up next, we've got a product called Clean Kit. Think of a time you were in a hurry to make it to a meeting and you would grab a snack and go. But uh-oh, the microwave is not clean. No worries. Clean Kit will make sure that doesn't happen again. Our third virtual presentation is from Maya Alford, a student at Woodlawn School in Baton Rouge, with her idea, Clean Kit.
Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Maya Alford, and I represent my company, Clean Kit LLC, where our mission is to make microwaves smile again. Now, before we get into this presentation, I just want to do a little clarification on the play on words here. Now, my generation has a bad habit of adding at the end of everything we don't want to do. Go wash the dishes. I don't want to mow the lawn. Do I have to? Parents, I know your kids have said this at least once. I'm even guilty of it myself. And ironically, my name just so happens to end with So that's where my product name comes from. So how exactly did this product come about? Well, my light bulb moment for me was while I was preparing to take a shower. I started to think about all the chores I had to complete the next day. And the first one that came to mind was the dreadful microwave. So as I put my shower bonnet on, I thought to myself, what if I could use this shower bonnet to keep my microwave clean? And that's how my product came about. Now, this is the problem that we face. Built up stains, splatters all over, messy juices covering the bottom of our microwaves. However, Maya's Clean Kit can eliminate this problem and ensure that your microwave never has to look like this again. So to take a look at some of the time that goes in these hard to clean boxes, it usually takes about 3 to 5 minutes to heat the average meal, 1 to 2 minutes to prevent a mess, 15 to 20 minutes to clean a microwave, and yet it only takes 2 to 3 minutes to order your clean kit. So now you're probably thinking, what is this clean kit and clean carousel that she keeps rambling about and what's so good about it? Well, for starters, our clean carousel is FDA approved, BPA free, non-stick, guaranteed to feel dishwasher safe. Ooh, and good thing that is a clean carousel, because unlike your typical glass carousel, ours is also shatterproof, so you never have to worry about cleaning up broken glass again. In addition, while this is just a prototype, our carousel also comes with high rim ridges to keep all spills contained in the carousel and center ridges to keep your dish from touching any of those messy juices at the bottom. Now, if you're looking to enhance your microwave or even make it look new again, here's where our clean kit comes into play. The first thing that comes in the kit is the clean solution. This solution you pop into your microwave for 3 minutes, and the steam breaks down any built-up stains that you may have in your microwave, making them easy to wipe right on out. In addition, it also lasts up to 10 uses. Next thing that comes in our kit is 50 disposable bonnet covers. Now, these covers are for one-time use only and fit perfectly around most glass carousels, keeping your carousel and your hands clean. The last thing that comes in the kit is the clean cover. Now, this is a splatter dome designed to channel all condensation back into the center of your carousel while also keeping splatters out of your microwave. So now you're probably thinking, okay, this kit sounds real nice, but I don't need everything that comes in the kit. Well, don't worry. You can order everything individually to fit your needs. Now, all of these are great products, and they're designed to make it easy for you to keep your microwave clean without having to bump an elbow or pull a muscle. But in making our products, we make sure that everything that we produce is environmentally friendly. With that being said, let us now take a look at costs. So the actual cost of all of our products, the clean solution, clean cover, bonnet covers, and the clean carousel, each cost $5.50 to make. As a result, they'll be sold at a retail price of $10.99. Our clean kit costs $17.50 to make, including packaging. It's going to be sold at a resale price of $39.99, leaving us with a profit of $5.49 per individual product sold and $22.49 per clean kit sold. Now, taking a look in the past, there have been over 62 patents filed in hopes to keep microwaves clean all around the world. So What exactly makes us different? It's simply the fact that many have tried, but none have quite succeeded like CleanKit has. In addition, what gives us a competitive advantage is the fact that we have guaranteed customer satisfaction and three-day delivery for anywhere across the United States. I mean, you can't compete when you don't compare. Taking a look at our target market, we simply want to target the over 90% of households who own a microwave. Whether it's a busy homeowner, a homeowner who has tried unsuccessfully to keep their microwave clean, college students on the go, typical bachelor or bachelorette, we want to target them all. As far as our methods of distribution go, we have a company website with minimal human interaction, we have a secure call center, and we're also looking to negotiate with companies like Walmart, Amazon, and even Target in the future. On top of that, we also have our product manufacturing company with strict guidelines and strict quality control. Now, taking a look at our revenue model here. Based off the following on the left being sold, we plan to have a gross profit of about $612,000, with operating expenses being $181,400, leaving us with a net profit before taxes of a little over $430,000. Today, I'm asking the panel for a loan of $100,000 for first-year runs only. Now, this is subject to change based on the market response and the demand of our product, and we also have a secure line of credit that will cover our operating expenses. With that being said, let us now take a look at Maya's CleanKit commercial.
Are you tired of opening your microwave and it looks like this? Well, thanks to CleanKit, your microwave never has to look like this again. Our kit comes with 50 disposable vinyl covers to keep your carousel clean, a clean cover to keep all splatters in, and a clean solution to break down any stains you may have built up for only $39.99. That's right, $39.99. Don't think that's enough? We also have a replacement carousel that's guaranteed to fit, shatterproof, dishwasher safe, FDA approved, BPA free, and nonstick for only $10.99. But wait, there's more. We have 100% customer satisfaction policy, so if our products don't work for you, we'll refund you your money.
Thanks to Maya's CleanKit, my microwave can smile again.
What are you waiting for? Call 1-800-CLEANKIT.
Thank you so much for your time. I hope you all enjoyed my presentation. I'll see you in the Q&A. Good afternoon, everybody.
Hi, Maya.
Hi.
Sorry, is that me? This is Karen W. Quick question on your marketing model. At the end, you said call this 800 number in order to order your product. Are you going to have an online solution or will you have to dial in to get the product? Thank you.
Yes, we have an online solution. We have a company website with minimal human interaction. And we also give you the option of calling our call center.
Thank you.
Maya, John Borlon, what is different about your cleaning solution or your cover from what else is on the market for microwaves?
Based on our solution, after doing much research, I couldn't find many solutions that really tackle the built-up stains that many people have in their microwaves. And as far as our splatter dome, this is just a prototype, and ours will be cone-shaped. And so actually the steam will just funnel right back into the center of your carousel and while also keeping splatters outside of your microwave.
Thank you.
Maya, this is Ross Barrett. First of all, excellent presentation, and you've got a super super positive voice and confidence, and that showed through quite well. So congrats on that. My question was on your finances. You indicated that you know it costs $550 to make, and you're going to retail it at $11. But you also said you were going to negotiate with Amazon. My guess is that your numbers may be a little off because Amazon and Walmart are not going to pass through all of those profits to you. Have you thought a little bit more detail on what you could actually sell it to Amazon or a retailer like Target or Walmart for?
As far as that, we would have to negotiate price changes. I would be willing to change the prices around a little bit in order to satisfy, you know, their company needs as well. So I would look into that as well.
Yeah, I think that's the key to your business because, as Karen said earlier, are you gonna sell it yourself, you know, online, versus if you're gonna sell it through a retailer. So, at any rate, I would consider that because I think it'll have an impact on your bottom line.
Hi, Mara, Matt Steller. Thank you so much for your presentation. And it certainly is an issue, not only at home, but in the office. As an example, in our office, we have many people using microwaves that they brown bag to work. How would you envision employing your products into a company that would have multiple users?
A kit is really what I play. We have 50 disposable bonnet covers to be able to cover your carousel to avoid having to wash that after every use or every month. And then we also have a solution if you want to break down any of those spills or stains. And so it'll make it easy for the janitorial staff to clean the microwave out with no hesitation, no issues. So just implementing the kit into your everyday lives, just keeping it on standby right by the microwave for your busy professionals would definitely be a great, you know, addition to the company.
Yeah, well, you know, my concern is, though, is if you would have 10 employees or 100 or 1,000, would they all need, you know, the splatterproof dome individually? Would they have to wash it after their use so the next employee could use it? And I guess the bigger question that I had today is because they make so many different size microwaves, and you're saying that it's guaranteed to fit, do you have multiple size platters for spills and for covers in order to fit different types of foods in different size microwaves?
Well, our clean carousel is what's guaranteed to fit most microwaves. We made it compatible from the smallest to largest microwaves. But as far as our splatter dome goes, you only need one per microwave, and it is dishwasher safe. So you'll be able to wash it as much as you would like or as much as you need to for companies with many employees who are using it.
Okay, thank you very much.
No problem.
Hi, this is Ada.
Ada, I'm sorry to cut you off. We are out of time for the questions. So that was our 5 minutes and you can hear the timer going off. Maya, I wanna thank you for your presentation. Judges, we're going to give you 3 minutes to complete your rubrics. Thank you. All right, judges, that is time. And I'd like to quickly thank Sam in New Orleans, who is the man behind the curtain, if you will, who's putting all this together for us today. Thank you so much, Sam. We are now on to a product called Safe Slit. Bailey Stoffsall and Alyssa Corona are seniors and soon to be faced with the many dangers of college and a new environment. One of these dangers includes the high sexual assault rate on college campuses. Their solution is the Safe Slit. The Safe Slit is a stylish, waterproof, chargeable, and discreet bracelet with the ability to instantly send your location to law enforcement or individuals in the event of danger. Our last virtual presentation today is from Bailey Stoffsall, and Bailey, I'm so sorry if I mispronounced your name, and Alyssa Corona. They are students out at Mount Carmel Academy in New Orleans. Take it away, ladies.
Americans are always pressed for time.
In 24 hours never seems like enough time in the day. However,
every 73 seconds, someone is sexually assaulted.
Every 20 minutes, an elder person dies from an unintended fall.
Every 29 minutes, a child is abducted.
Every 3.4 minutes,
every 3.2 seconds,
every minute, someone is
every minute, every minute, you are unsafe.
Our solution, the Safe Slit.
What is the Safe Slit? A stylish, waterproof, chargeable, and discreet bracelet with the ability to send your location to the closest law enforcement in the event of danger. You push a button down for 5 seconds and immediately alerts the police, and a green light will come on. If you want the request to easily be undone, you double press the button and the light will turn off.
Safe Slit, safety made stylish.
The Safe Slit by Alyssa Corona.
And Bailey Shawstall.
Safety made stylish.
Our problem. During the first semester, our high school held a panel for the seniors about college campus safety. This panel caused us to realize how much more susceptible we are to sexual assault and violence on campus. Once the panel was over, Alyssa and I instantly knew our idea, a product to keep women on college campuses, soon to be ourselves, safe.
25% of women are victims of forced or pressured sex. 1 in 5 women will be sexually assaulted in college, and 90% of college cases are unreported.
Our solution?
The Safe Slit, a stylish, waterproof, chargeable, and discreet bracelet with the ability to instantly send your location to law enforcement or a trusted individual in the event of danger.
You may be wondering how it all works. You push the button down for 5 seconds, and the light on the side of the bracelet will turn green. The request can easily be undone by double pressing the button, and the green light will turn off.
The Safe Slit comes in a variety of different colors and patterns. The bands can come in silicone, basic, and pastel colors and animal print patterns, as well as faux leathers and specialty chains.
Our customer is primarily college students, particularly females and young women against sexual assault, but we wanted to expand to parents so that they have the ability to track their young children, homeowners in the event of an invasion or fire, senior citizens in the event of an accident or fall, or commuters in busy and unsafe cities.
The cost of our product is $28. If you were to order a specialty band, the price rises to $30. All bands come with a lifetime warranty. In order to purchase our product, you can visit our personal website as well as our partnering companies, Amazon, Target, QVC, and your local college bookstores.
Our competition includes the Apple Watch, the Life Alert, and the Buddy Tag. While we are aware that the Apple Watch has a similar feature to our product, the Apple Watch is far more expensive than our product, and when using the SOS feature on the watch, an alarm sounds before contacting the police, which is not very discreet. Life Alert is our personal emergency response system. However, the necklace has to be in the range of the necklace's control box, and while Life Alert does provide an emergency phone, they rarely reliably connect to the control center outside of the home because of the faulty batteries. The Buddy Tag is a tracking bracelet for young children in which the parent can track their child through the website with a chip in the child's bracelet. However, it isn't waterproof, often alarms without cause, and does not accurately update the child's location in real time. What makes us better? The Safe Slit ensures that traveling around college campuses around your home or your city is much safer. It's simpler and more discreet than trying to call 911 or a trusted individual in an unsafe or chaotic situation. It gives a pinpointable location in order to find you. The customizable bands make it very discreet, and our price comparison is unbeatable.
In order to inform people of our product, we will be marketing the SafeSlit on social media platforms such as Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube, as well as on our personal website. Our company will also visit college campuses to continue to spread our product to the public and start an ad campaign to shift more focus to sexual assault awareness. We need your help. For our product and service to start up, we will need $165,000 in order to partner with known companies so our product can be easily accessible for purchase, market our product on multiple platforms so it gains recognition, manufacture the SafeSlit sold within the first year, and patent our idea so it cannot be stolen or repeated. Also, we would like to expand our service by having a command center to send the location to so the employees can notify the closest law enforcement in your vicinity, and to create an app to connect your location to a trusted individual.
The SafeSlit.
Stay smart, stay stylish, stay safe.
SafeSlit. Thank you for your time. Hello.
Thank you. Great presentations. Same question as with the first group, and that is there a cost to have service from the police department to react to the alert? Thank you.
Obviously, contacting the police and getting them to work with us is going to be a huge issue. So we wanted to focus on partnering with college campuses and their security systems first to see how we could work out any kinks. And also work towards an ad campaign against sexual assault. So we would focus more on our local colleges like LSU, Tulane, ULO, so we could see how it would work, because we also want to get an app in the future so you can contact trusted individuals. But as far as the police in your city, we would like to see how the college thing works out first. But obviously, there's going to be a fee, so.
Thank you.
Ladies, this is Ross Barrett. Nice presentation. It was really well put together, so congratulations. My question has to do with your competition with the Apple Watch. Apple's notorious for filing patents to quash potential competition like this. What happens if you find your watch infringing one of their patents?
Well, our watch uses a Bluetooth connection, and it doesn't use a cellular such as the Apple Watch. You can get an Apple Watch without cellular, which is the cheaper one. But as far as if we cannot patent it, then that may be an issue. But ours uses similar technology to a Fitbit or a Tile tracking watch. So I wouldn't say it's necessarily, it's not touchscreen. It's not necessarily comparable to the Apple Watch. But I mean, as in terms of them filing a lawsuit, then that could be an issue.
Yeah, no, that's fair enough. It's more of just pointing it out to you than looking for an answer right now. So nice job. Thank you.
Good job, ladies. Hey,
Alyssa.
You said a rechargeable battery. Why, since the only function really is to be the safe alert, why would you not have more of a watch type battery that could last 5 or 6 years?
We thought about putting the small circular batteries in, but as we found out, the Life Alert also uses those batteries, and so does the Buddy Tag, and people often complain that, the batteries would get wet and not work, or they just wouldn't work at all or reliably connect to, another individual. The Buddy Tag's batteries wouldn't connect to the website in which you use to find where your child's location is. So we thought it would be best to just use a chargeable system, because also, let's just say your thing dies and you're more likely to have a charger in your car or with you at all times than, let's say, batteries.
Bailey, Alyssa, Matt Stuller, great presentation. Just a little clarity, if you will, on this $165,000 equity position. Is that a loan? Is that equity in the business with a certain percentage of ownership? Can you explain that a little bit more?
We were hoping that you know, obviously it would be more of like a loan. And then when we started expanding more and making more revenue back, that it would be around like 40% in our company, because with our initial $165,000, we're not gonna be able to like start up our app and have our command center, because obviously that's gonna cost more money. So we want to focus primarily on college campuses and getting them to work with us in local security rather than on a large scale. So hopefully like when we are able to expand and start generating more revenue, then we will be able to give them 40% in our company.
Okay, thank you.
Hi, this is Ada, great product. So what do you see your sales strategy being to grow this business? Archie Grow is gonna be a product line. What? How do you see growing it?
We wanted to market it more towards a safety product that fights against, you know, things such as sexual assault and helping in a chaotic and unsafe situation. So we wanted to focus more on ad campaigns, like such as sexual assault ad campaigns and stuff like that, and working with college campuses and young women and other organizations that could use this product. Louisiana is, I think, 13th in sexual assault. So obviously, you know, it's a big problem down here. And so obviously starting locally, that would really help us, you know, expand further in the future.
Okay, great. Thank you.
Okay, everyone, time is now up. And we now give the judges 3 minutes to complete their rubrics. All right, judges, our time is up. And can you believe it? We've seen all four finalists. I want to thank all the teams for participating today. And someone we really want to thank is all the teachers who worked with the students and all the mentors that helped to make this happen. What a cool experience. Once again, we want to thank our sponsors as well for today's event: the Breeze Dream Foundation, Cox Business, Home Bank, Blue Cross Blue Shield of Louisiana, and Kiwanis of Lafayette. And I just want to say, as a board member for Junior Achievement in the Lafayette area, we take your sponsorships very seriously, and you can see what the money you donate to Junior Achievement is doing by taking a look at this presentation today. So right now, the judges are going to take just a few moments to finalize their scores. Once they've submitted all of their scores, our auditors from Postlethwaite and Netterville will verify each team's scores, and then they're going to send it to me, and then we're going to announce the winners. So as those scores are being verified by our auditors now, we're going to take just a few moments to hear from Brandon Kelly at Home Bank.
All right, good afternoon. Congratulations to our finalists of the Junior Achievement Trust Your Crazy Ideas Challenge. Each year at Home Bank, we talk to hundreds of new entrepreneurs pitching their businesses, and I must say these were very impressive presentations. Over the last few months, the class of 2020 has been described as resilient, but you guys are more than that. You are problem solvers, you're passionate, you're compassionate, you're determined, you're focused, and you're willing to take on challenges head on. And all of these are skills that are vital to being a great entrepreneur. So keep going. And when you are ready to start your multi-million dollar business, or you just want some more information on a checking account, just know that you always have a home at Home Bank. So on behalf of our board of directors, our 462 employees in Louisiana and Mississippi, Home Bank wishes you all congratulations and best of luck. Great job, guys.
Thank you so much, Brandon. And thanks to Home Bank, who is a wonderful sponsor. And once again, we recognize all of our sponsors: the Breeze Dream Foundation, Cox Business, Home Bank, Blue Cross Blue Shield of Louisiana, and Kiwanis of Lafayette. Right now, the scores are still being tabulated, but can we all agree that this has been such a cool experience? I want to thank all the students for all of their hard work in making this happen. And of course, I'm excited to tell you, we're giving away about $30,000 today. Each team is going to at least receive $2,500, and that will be split among the team, and then the school they attend will also receive $2,500. The winner today, though, the state winner is going to receive $10,000, and their school receives $5,000. And we've seen how this money really does help to teach financial literacy programs at schools. And as many of our judges and our adults that are joining right now know, financial literacy is so important and something that not all children have access to when they are not in a classroom that has those types of programs available. So that's one of the things that Junior Achievement does across the state. We have so many cool programs that are utilized to teach financial literacy in classrooms. So anyone who's on the call right now, if you have not already, I do encourage you to reach out to the Junior Achievement in your area, because there are lots of volunteer opportunities where you can go into classrooms with children from kindergarten all the way to high school to teach kids about financial literacy. I'm going to press mute right now because it looks like I have a message coming in, and I'm hoping that it's the results. So we'll be back in just a second. Thank you. everyone. I just wanted to let you know we are still tabulating scores. When it takes this long, there are only two possibilities on what could be going on. Number one, you have not got Cox high-speed internet. Your internet is slow. Number two, the other option is our teams were so incredible that the judges are really having to take their time to tally their scores. And I'm going to go with option two because I'm going to trust that everyone who can have Cox internet already has it. So I see that the results are now starting to come in to the agency that is watching them, Postal Weight and Netterville. They're going to verify those results. We'll play that snazzy little tune one more time, and then we should have the results on the winners. Once again, students, you did such a wonderful job. Lots of suspense here, but it's nice to see everyone's smiling faces on the screen. We'll have an answer for you on the winners very soon. You guys, we're still working on it, but let me have no fear. We have everything coming in and quite soon. So I want to thank everyone for their patience. As you know, this is our very first time to do this virtually. Just like I forgot to turn my camera on. This is our very first time to do this virtually. So we're learning as we go. But I did notice one common theme today. Did you guys notice the same thing that I noticed? Every single finalist today is female. That's pretty awesome. I'm happy to see that across the board. And we are happy to see so many people that have joined us today, both through this Zoom meeting and through to the Developing Lafayette page, which is sharing this post as well. So we'll do one more musical interlude, and I'm hopeful by that point we will have a winner selected. I could find the mute button. Guess what? We have a winner. I'm so excited to share the results with you now. Once again, I wanted to remind everyone, we're going to have three runner-ups that are mentioned in no particular order, and we're going to have one winner. So our first runner-up is coming in from Baton Rouge, Maya Alford with Clean Kit, Woodlawn High School. Maya, congratulations. You received $2,500, and so does your school. Our next runner-up coming in from Acadiana. And Acadiana is the team that came from Turlings Catholic High School. And I am finding their names right here. It is the Plan Pals, Haley Prevot, Olivia Leonard, and Emma Lemaire. Congratulations, Acadiana, $2,500 for your school and $2,500 for you. Our next finalist comes in from the city of New Orleans. Bailey Schaufstall and Alyssa Corona from Mount Carmel Academy, $2,500 for you and $2,500 for Mount Carmel Academy. And in first place today, Shreveport. Congratulations, Haley DeRamas and Lauren Wise with Traceline. You are the winner of $10,000, and so is your school. How awesome is that? Congratulations to everyone. Thank you so much for participating. Let's all give them a virtual round of applause. That's awesome. I want to thank all of our judges. I want to thank everyone for joining us now. Thank you for attending our first virtual Trust Your Crazy Idea event to celebrate with us today. And thank you for your support of Junior Achievement. Congratulations again to all of our students and their families on their crazy cool ideas. I know you all have very bright futures ahead. We'll see you next year, hopefully in person, for the 2021 Trust Your Crazy Ideas Challenge. Thanks, everyone.
Thanks, everybody. Right on. Congrats, Shreveport. Good work.
Thank you. Are we all on?
There's a whole bunch of people on here, but this is awesome. I'm going to go ahead and end this because we're all done. And
yay!
All
the lights and
everything. Congratulations, Shreveport, and everybody else doing all this.
Thank you.
Congratulations, Traceline.
Hold on a second. Girls. Nita, could we meet at the office and take a picture?
Yes.
Girls, can y'all meet at the office in an hour or so?
Yeah, we can meet right now.
Let's do 30 minutes. Let's just get this done.
Okay.
Let's just go. I'm going to go ahead and go.
All right, okay. We'll meet you there.
Congratulations. We're taking a picture.
Yes. You're awesome. And you look good. You're picking